Hey guys, what's going on? It's me, Irma, back here again. And today, I'm sorry for recording for a little, so basically, I wanted to record for a earlier ago, like a really hours ago or something. But I was actually making something. If I didn't correct that, so I don't know why everyone's already being super duper quiet. But so basically, I was actually creating the Bloody Painter from Creepypasta. Of course, he's also popular as well. I see him sometimes in the Vines videos of the Creepypastas, and that was amazing. So basically, yeah. I don't know why everyone's still looking at me like that, but so basically, yeah. So of course, I created him. I was about to create the puppetry right now from Creepypasta as well, but I just literally wanted to make this video. And today, I didn't go to my cochin, which is actually pretty good because, you know. I'm sorry, what is this? Why didn't you go there? I could have literally gone today, but so today, look at the weather outside. I'm sorry, look at the weather. It's I think it shows it's gonna be kind of cloudy and rainy. I'm not pretty sure, so that's why I get to stay in. Oh, come on. And also because I literally took my vaccine. I'm sorry, what? Look, I mean, is it called a vaccination? I think it's called vaccination, I think. I don't know. Because I thought it's always called vaccine, but because I heard some of my classmates, they were talking about it. Like, they don't wanna take the vaccination or something, but I already took it. I can't believe I'm actually the only person in my class that I actually took the vaccine. I was the only person who took it, and the others didn't. Yeah, I don't know why all of you are being so quiet all of a sudden, but basically, I'm getting excited today. So basically, I literally had fun reading the cute-looking wet pet story a long time ago, although I'm not sure about what happened. I mean, I can't believe there's so many chapters, and remember the time we were talking about their I don't know, personalities with us or something. I mean, their relationship with us. I really literally read all of it, but then I literally stumbled up looking at there as a lot of chapters still going. I don't know, but that was so cute though, adorable and all those stuff. And of course, you can see Nezuko and Jeff over there. They're on top of. I'm sorry, what is this? Am I supposed to be happy about it, or am I supposed to be? I don't know. I'm sorry. This is. Look, shut up. I bet I was saying. So basically, nah, Jay actually tripping. Look, shut up. But I was saying. So basically, I don't know what to do about it, anyways. But Nah, what is this? I'm sorry, what is this? Look, so this is like a video I was looking at. Look at that. Nezuko kicks off Daki's head, Demon Slayer Season 2, or S2 for short, you know. That's basically what it says. And this is like B World. Oh, yeah. Wait, does it mean blood warning? But I don't see any blood anywhere, though. But okay. Nah, you're actually mad. But the most thing, so look at the description. I tried. Hashtag Demon Slayer, hashtag Kimetsu no Yaiba, hashtag Nezuko Kamado, hashtag Nezuko versus Daki. Oh, I love it how she didn't put anything about hashtag Daki or something, but okay. What? But the thing, so this is actually a video made by them, oh, look at that, on the 29th of July in, how to say, in 2022, so it was basically last year. Isn't this, so cool? I actually, liked this video a long time ago. Look at that, 60 likes. I'm sorry, this should actually get more likes. Look at the views. I don't know, but I want to be as, I don't know, good as them. Look at that, I can never, but okay. So this is actually, the audio being used in this video. So you know, Doja Cat, so basically she made a song, years ago probably, you know Streets? So that song, I mean, it's a pretty, how do you say, pretty popular, and I really like that from her. So basically, it's also on TikTok and all those other trends going on, you know? So basically, that is the meme being used, I mean, on here. I mean, it doesn't actually say meme anywhere, so I'm just hoping this is like a, I don't know, like a video. It doesn't say meme nowhere, but you know. This is amazing, isn't it? I just love it so much. Yeah, you love it because Nezuko is your favorite. Look, of course. Oh, come on. She is my favorite. I know that, but nah, what the. I'm sorry. Look, so, come on. How is this that traumatizing? She just literally cut open her head. That's so normal about it. Yeah, I don't know why you're being so quiet all of a sudden, but yeah, so basically, so this is actually a thing. Look, this is actually a copy and paste that I started, searched on my YouTube. So basically, if we search that up, so it's basically saying, it's not like a video, it's basically from YouTube Shorts. So it says, I don't care what people say, creepypasta, shitpost. So basically, of course, if you know who that is, that's our lovely Jeff over there. Yeah, I don't know why you're being so quiet. Can you guys hear the volume? And I can't believe they're I like their Jeff design because a lot of them I mean, they did it. They do actually put, like, make him have nose or make him have no nose. But, like, this Jeff, can you see that? It's like, so basically, this kind of Jeff design is the same as mine because his nostrils kind of, like, pointing up in the situation kind of looks like an alien, if you know what an alien looks like. But not that much, though. But, you know, I don't know why you're being so quiet, though. But, yeah. This is so beautiful. I think I know how to say it. It's like, I don't care what people... I want to say, like, in a song version, but I just don't want to. I'm too shy, like... Nah, what the freak is this? Look, basically, the realist is... I don't care... Okay, fine, I'm not gonna, like, waste your guys' time on literally singing. This is not a singing video anyways, but, like... Okay, it says, I don't care what people say. The rush is the price I... The rush is the price I pay. I get so high when you're with me. And then something others. What does it say again? Yeah. Oh, the rush is worth the price I pay. Yeah, I always thought it was like, the rush is what I pay. No, I mean, I don't know. This is amazing. Did you see how Jeff's eyes... I'm sorry, I think he's blushing. I don't know, but like his eyes literally turned into heart shapes. Oh my god. What the... Look, you can call me that I'm a... Okay, so basically, another video I made today. I thought I have no... So basically, I'm gonna say it later, but look at this. Let me just see something. Was he actually blushing? Oh. So maybe he did, because in the background, it's basically like flashing lights of like, how do you say it? Like red, and maybe that was blue as well. Let me see. Oh, it's just red. This is lovely. So basically, I don't know why, because I literally took my like a vaccination like maybe 2 days ago, yeah. So I don't know why my hand is still aching. Like, I don't know, it just keeps on hurting a lot. I'm sorry, what? Look, you know that I literally took the needle thing from my high school and like basically it still hurts on my hand. I don't know, it kind of aches for a moment, I don't know. This literally comes, look, oh my god, it's literally happening again. I'm sorry, are you okay? Oh, yeah, Jeff, I'm perfectly fine, don't worry about me, I'm just, I don't know, the pain kind of comes and it just goes away, so. Why did you take the needle, though? Like, why did you take the vaccination for, like, oh, I don't know, it's basically for my, I don't know, like, my health or something, like, for me to, like, literally, like, stay healthier or something, you know. Oh, yes, 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 totally important, what do you say, Ben? Yes, yes. Yeah, I don't know why all of you are being so quiet right now, but as I was saying, yeah, this is beautiful, isn't it? Yeah, I literally forgot, I literally had it on my thing right now, on my search on YouTube. So basically, this is another one. Isn't this, I don't know what kind of song this is from, but I've been, what is this? Wait, aren't they the same person? Oh, they are the same person. Luna Escape, I think. Wait, what is it? Let me see. Yeah. Luna Escape. Oh, they also have a YouTube channel. They actually make videos as well. Let me see. What is this? A big shot. Let me see. What is this? Now is your chance to be a big shot. Creepypasta, OC, animation meme. I don't know what this M... Is it M... I mean, no. PMV. Oh, yeah. PMV. I think I know what that means. A lot of them use that for some reason. I don't know. I really love how many people... Look at that. 1 year ago. I'm sorry. People are just like going back to their creepypasta phase. I like this. And I feel like... Jeff is getting better every single day. I don't know why. Like, I'm sorry. Look, shut up. As I was saying, this actually, I haven't seen this meme. Let me just see if I notice this meme or not. Nope, I don't know it. Oh no, I haven't seen. Yeah, actually, I haven't seen this meme. Oh, they should have actually added the proxies right now. So they added... They added Ben, they added Jack, Eyeless Jack, they also added Jeff. And I think they're supposed to be the OC. Yeah, these are... What is this? It's too early for this. Oh, okay. Wait, so that's a laughing Jack, that's Jane the Killer, and that's Sally. Oh, I love it how, oh, if you realize, oh no, okay, that's perfectly fine, because I thought she was wearing white pants under that, but it's actually like socks, I think, yeah. Oh, they should have actually added the proxies right now, like, you know, Toby, Masky, and Hoodie, but okay. So basically, let's go to the main point on why I decided to make this video. So basically, my dream came true again. I basically had another creepypasta dream. But this time, I think I saw Jane most of the time than the others. I think the others were back or something, I don't know. Nah. Look, it's actually, it doesn't, no. Basically, it's not one of my OCs. Like, I basically changed a lot of my OC designs right now, some of them though. So yeah, Jane's design, she basically has the same kind of like haircut, like Raven now. You know Raven from Teen Titans or Teen Titans Go? You know how her hair is like cut short in the situation or something? I don't know, she just, I think, I don't really know about that. Like I said, I don't actually read the comics or anything, but you know. So her hair, like her haircut is basically like the same as Raven. I feel like a lot of people actually make her, I mean draw her like that. Not a lot, but like sometimes they do. And also a YouTuber as well, I forgot about their channel name, but you know. So basically, yeah, I got inspired by that, and now I think I kind of, look, I'm gonna like, I don't know, put the inspiration in the description once I actually upload my video about the creepypastas as vines in Gacha Club, so, yeah, because I actually got inspired by a lot of things from their outfit and their designs and, you know, not the skin color to her, because the skin color of the other Jane from their, how do you say it, thing, I think she basically had like a lighter skin, but I basically put my darker skin, just like Jeff basically, so you know. All of them pretty much have darker skins, except for like Masky, because he kind of like has that kind of problem or something. It basically says on the Marble Hornets, I think, because he needs to take his pills right now and all those stuff. And the Hoodie as well, but Hoodie is kind of a little darker, but you know what I mean. Oh, I want to show you guys, it's so bad, my designs of the creepypastas, oh my god. I'm still working on them, I have to create a lot of them. So I already created Bloody Painter today. I need to create the Puppeteer. I need to, you know, Emra. So basically, I think I'm saying it right, Emra. So basically, yeah, Emra is the, so I didn't know what she was. I thought she was like a Ballora from FNAF, Sister Location, how do you say, inspired character or something, but she actually wasn't. I think she was, I'm not pretty sure, so if I search up her name right now, yeah, there you go, Emra from Creepypasta, full body, so I actually wanted, I don't know, she's most of the time, her fan arts are with the Puppeteer right now, so, you know, if I go to her fandom, Wikipedia, I mean, it's basically Wiki, come on, hello, oh, there we go, thank you, so basically, look at that, so yeah, look at that, Emra. So basically, she's so much similar to, how do you say it, Ballora from FNAF Sister Location. So look at the Emra. Emra is the Puppeteer's main and first proxy. She is an undead doll. But why does she look a lot, yeah, so, basically, undead doll. I'm sorry, what does undead mean again? Let me just see something. Nah, Jeshu tripping. Look, I just want to know what is the meaning of it. Let me just see. What does, is it like, I don't know, let me just see. There we go. Oh, wait, well, of a fictional being, especially a vampire, technically dead, but still animate. Oh!
Undead.
Oh, okay, so basically that is the thing of that thing right now. So basically, yeah, undead doll, who was given the power to reform and change her appearance through her own will, even though she lives through endless abuse as a puppet. She treasures her puppet master dearly through a deep connection and love. So, yeah, that's a beautiful thing, though. Origin. In life, Emra obeyed the will of near everyone around her. Her parents, in particular, dreamed of a life of stardom, yeah, I think, yeah, stardom, and thus put her in ballet. I mean, is it, yeah, courses at an early age. She continued with this throughout her life and ended up developing a passion for theater. Oh, okay. There she's, what? Where she met Jonathan. Okay. With her high school graduation around a corner, she was given an ultimate, I mean, it doesn't say that. I mean, ultimatum, I think, I don't know. Go to high-end college to ensure, I think, yeah, ensure a stable future. or reject her parents' wishes and leave with Jonathan with a heavy heart, she chose to pursue a more stable future for herself after her death. Emra was recreated into the first and only living doll the puppeteer was constructed. She continues to hold the title of his masterpiece, despite having the emotions of a normal human being. She retains the memories of her former life, something she holds dear to her heart, often fantasizing about what could have been. Oh, through her transformation, she was given the power to reform and mimic the appearance of others. Oh, okay. As long as she knows what their face and body look like, she can recreate nearly any person. While her strengths lie in mimicking appearances, she is incredibly fragile, like one would expect a doll to be. So she's a doll, and I thought she was like the same copy, as Ballora, because she looks a lot like Ballora, but like the color schemes are different. Ballora has like blue hair, yeah, and like she has like a purple skirt or something and a blue dress. I mean, not really a blue dress, it's kind of like a bit revealing, if you know what I mean, from Ballora. So, yeah, and also for Emra, it's kind of the same thing. And I thought that they were supposed to be, and I thought that that's supposed to be like Ballora's dark version from the creepypastas or something. I don't know, but like, that's cool, because then Emra basically has a black hair, her eyes are red, and she basically wears a red, like a ballerina dress. Wow, that's a beautiful thing. Let me see, create nearly any person while her strengths, okay. Yeah, she is incredibly fragile, like one would expect a doll to be. Oh, okay, and I thought she was an animatronic, sorry. Because she breaks so easily, she often needs the puppeteer to perform repairs to keep her form, from falling apart completely. While Emra's Devotion, to her lost love, now master, seems unconditional. Her alliance becomes conflicted with the introduction of, is it Zachary? Okay, yeah, Zachary, I think. Yeah, Zachary. Zachary soon became son to her. A son who can influence Emra to rethink her love for the puppeteer. Oh, that's lovely. So basically, she's also a creepypasta. She is like, she's most drawn with the puppeteer anyway. So I want to feel like seeing the video. Like I didn't see the puppeteers or the others, like Sonic.exe. Oh my god. So basically, yeah, those are the other creepypastas. Oh my god. Why do I keep forgetting to actually see the backstories of them? I'm sorry. Look at that, the puppeteers. There we go. I was actually willing to create him, but I didn't. I don't know why. So he actually has a voice line. Oh, can you get away? Okay, there we go. That's like a little advertising thing which came up. I don't know. The puppeteer. They call me the puppeteer. From the puppeteer. You're alone here, aren't you? A common phrase from the puppeteer. I'm your only friend. Another common phrase from the puppeteer. The puppeteer is the tutelar central antagonist of the creepypasta story of the same name, the puppeteer, and is featured in other creepypastas. Oh. So, yeah, he basically has his own, let's actually read this if I want to, I don't know, I wanna, like, read Sonic's, though, like, oh my god, that would actually make more sense. I'm sorry, look, I don't know how did Sonic basically have, like, a virus, and now his name is Sonic.exe, I don't know, none of that stuff. If you play the game, you will just see Sonic literally, standing in the edge of, like, the hills or something, then when Tails literally go near him, then he basically jump scares Tails or something, I'm not pretty sure, but yeah, that's the origin, of the puppeteer. I think I am saying this right, I'm not pretty sure, but like, yeah, I'm not sure if I'm gonna read another wet pet story or something, but that was fun reading, that was adorable, my heart. But I was saying, okay, the puppeteer is a vengeful spirit who feeds on loneliness and depression. He targets the emotionally Fadual, using them for his own gain and power. He will stalk a victim for a certain period of time, slowing, twisting them into believing that there is no way from escaping life's torment other than death. Although the puppeteer works alone, his two unwilling proxies, Zachary... Okay, who is this Zachary person? I know he basically has two proxies right now. I think he is a creepypasta or something. Oh my god, that's the Bloody Painters. Okay, Jason the Toy... Okay, I haven't created Jason the Toymaker. I want to create Sonic.exe. I also want to create the puppeteer, of course. I'm not pretty sure about the Emra, because she's like one of the puppeteer's proxies, so maybe I'm not pretty sure. There's also a different one. You know Kate the Chaser? I did actually watch her backstory, and she is totally a proxy of Slenderman. But like, she isn't that featured from any of the fanarts, so she's not that popular. The only popular character over here is Toby, if you know who that is, of course. Oh my god, look at this. This is my wallpaper on Google, basically. So that's Ben, that's Jane, that's Sally, that's Smile Dog, that's Jeff, that's Lou or Leo, I'm not pretty sure. Because I'm just gonna say Lou, okay? Yeah, that's Lou, that's Bloody Painter. Okay, so basically, now I literally remember. Okay, this is Judge Angels. So, is it Judge Angels? Yeah, Judge Angels. That's Slenderman, that's Toby. That's Clockwork being moody, literally putting her middle finger up. That is Eyeless Jag, that is Hoodie, that is Masky, and that's the puppeteer right there. I wish there was more characters, to be honest, but okay, who is this Zachary person, I wonder? Let me just see. Not the Inquisitor Master, no, I mean, if you know who they are, they're pretty, let me just see. Oh, yeah, it's him, oh, Zach, oh, so this it's basically, he's supposed to be maybe the boyfriend of Alex, I'm not pretty sure. So, Zachary from Creepypastas. He's supposed to be famous, I think, I don't know. But I was saying, Creepypasta. There we go. Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, that's lovely. Yeah, this is, okay, yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah, I don't actually, this is my first time actually seeing this character, to be honest. But that's cool, I guess. okay. Zachary and Emra, the one we actually talked about the other time, few minutes ago basically, are used in a special occasions for when he needs a quick snack. Okay. They will seclude. Yeah, I think seclude the victim in different ways, making the hunt much easier for the puppeteer. The demonic protagonist, that says something else, I don't know, was once a normal teenage boy by the name of, this is making more sense now, I guess, okay, Jonathan, Blake, I think, yeah, Blake, who after a horrible break up with the love of his life, secluded himself away from human contact, when he found no reason to continue, he locked himself in a room and hung himself, leaving his body to be found a few weeks later. But Blake's spirit awoke once more, filled with worth and anger as he transformed into the vicious spirit known as the puppeteer, seen as his life was filled with decisions made for him. Within the afterlife, the ghost was finally able to take control of his own life and choices, believing a standard human name wouldn't suit him any longer. He renamed himself as the puppeteer to work behind the curtains and control humans the same way someone would control a puppet would become his reason to exist. Oh, that's a beautiful... Nah, no way did you read that whole paragraph. Look, of course I did. How many... Oh, yeah, actually, there's a literally three paragraphs. Okay, that's lovely. I'm sorry. Look, okay, so basically, I'm not pretty sure if I'm gonna have, like, the rabbit hole power of mine. I don't know, because in My Hero Academia, I basically created two quirks of mine. And quirks are basically superpowers or whatever you want to call it. So basically, I'm going to say quirks. So basically, my, how do you say it? My quirk is basically two quirks. I have one to basically, how do you say, control people, like a, basically like a, you know, the mother spider from Demon Slayer. So she basically creates like webs from her fingertips, and she basically can control people, with her fingertips right now. I'm not sure, because should I do that? I just feel like I'm kind of copying the puppetry. I didn't actually know him that quite a long time ago before, I don't know, searching his name up and, you know, all those stuff. So basically, yeah. I don't know why Relish being so quiet, though. But the next one is a rabbit hole. So I can basically, like, control... I don't know, basically make a rabbit hole from my bare hands or from my bare toes. I don't know. If I step on something, that will create, like, a rabbit hole. You know what I mean? I'm not pretty sure. I should actually have one, though. I don't know, basically. Yeah, I don't know why all of you are being so quiet. But as I was thinking, this is lovely, isn't it? Wait. Okay, let me just read this. Should I? I don't know. Okay, yeah, the puppeteer, this is the appearance. The puppeteer is described as being lean and tall, standing at 6'3". He has an intimidating demeanor, I think. I don't know. His style of clothing is a grungly. I don't know, like, sporting a black trench coat, hoodie, undershirt, jeans, sneakers, and beanie. Wait, beanie? Wait, what do you mean by that? Nah, what the freak? Look, shut up, I just said that by accident. I don't... That actually says beanie, though. I don't know what it... What does it mean, actually? Let me just copy and paste it. Hopefully, it will literally let me this time. I'm sorry, what? Look, I do not know, but I don't know. Can't believe I should have actually watched the video. Oh, so this is a beanie. Oh, okay, yeah. So it's basically... Oh, yeah, it's basically the hat that he's wearing. Oh, okay. I don't actually know some of these old-style clothings, just saying, I don't know. I'm not sure if this is old clothings, I don't know, old-style clothings. After awaking as the puppeteer, his original light tanned the skin and, had turned gray. His hair color also changed from dark brown to jet black. Oh, so that must be him in the past. It's a Jonathan, I think. Jonathan. Yeah, Jonathan. That was used to be his past name. Human name, basically, and his eyes are now golden yellow. Brown was his original eye color. Oh, so basically you can see every single creepypastas have a backstory, and I'm also creating my own as well. Like, can't believe I actually had a dream, no joke. I'm sorry, this time I actually saw Jane. I'm not sure, because the others were basically behind, like, the literally behind her or something, I don't know, but I just saw Jane, and that's all. I actually saw the original because, you know, when she was actually wearing a mask, because her whole skin color is pale white. And I didn't actually dream about my OC, like my design of Jane in the Gacha Club, though. But, you know, that was amazing. Wow. Next time, I want to see someone else now. Who should I go with? I'm sorry. Yeah, I don't know why all of you are being so quiet. But as I was saying, I think a long time ago, I did have a dream about Sonic.exe. I don't know. It's probably because you think of... Look, Oh, how can you... Exactly, I sort of got shut up. Look, and I thought you said he was your favorite. Look, I don't know. I think it was a really long time ago. I can't remember, but maybe I did. I'm not pretty sure. But I think he was tormenting me right now. He was literally making my... I don't know, making me, like, I don't know, kill me or something. I'm not pretty sure. But I want to feel like having Slenderman or have a dream about, how do you say it? Smile Dog or Greeny Cat. Neither of them. I want to have all of their dreams, basically. Like... I don't know why my dreams of creepypastas are really, like, small, though. I want to have, like, a long time of literally seeing them for my whole life when I go to sleep. And yeah, I don't know why you're being so quiet, but as I was saying, where was I again? The puppeteer has two body forms, one where he is completely transparent, and one where he is able to produce a very solid form. The transparent, is it appearation is where he's the most, presentable with. Transparent, so it's basically like, you know, in this form, he can stalk and prey upon his victims without spending too much energy. Meanwhile, with the solid form, his only ability to become completely solid when he needs to grab a hold of something or someone. This is used mostly when he finishes a kill. Tears and saliva stains around his eyes and mouth. His arms are too well crafted dolls Is it prosthetics? I don't know. personality, okay. Method of killing, yeah. Wow, that's a lot. Wow, sister. That's lovely. Okay, that's a lot. Okay. I'm sorry. I swear I saw bloody painters. Although I do know what happened to his story. Oh, Jason. I don't know. I want to do, like, all of them. Okay, that is also... Okay, guy... Is it... I mean, Kagi Kayo. Yeah, Kaki Kayo, I think. I don't know. So he's also creepypasta as well. All of them, okay. Let's go to Bloody Painters. Oh, wow. Why does this look like a real-life version? Yeah, I do not know. That looks amazing, though. Let me see. Bloody Painter. Bloody Painter is a fictional serial killer character from the Creepypasta series. The character is featured as the protagonist of a three-part story created by artist Dilucat. Okay. Since his debut, I think, I don't know, Bloody Painter's growing influence has encouraged many related projects and stories to spawn. Oh, okay. Appearance, Helen. Okay, so that's oh my god. I'm sorry. Look, I sort of got shut up. Let me just finish my thing. Okay, so basically, okay, this is the appearance. Helen Otis, is a pale man with black hair and blue eyes. He wears a blue jacket with a yellow smiley face pin as Bloody Painter. He wears leather gloves and a white mask with blackened eyes and a red smile. Not bad. I mean, I'm sorry, is that actually like a red paint or is that his victim's blood? I'm not pretty sure. It's basically like craved into a mask. Oh, yeah. I don't know why you're being so quiet. What was I saying? Okay, personality. He is very calm and quiet. Oh, just like me. I mean, I'm not really calm though when it's about my friends or... I mean, to be honest, I'm like the quiet kid in my friend's circle group in the situation. Like, he's a lot like me, to be honest. Like, literally, I'm a good artist and he as well, like... Yeah, I don't know why you're being so quiet. Like, thank you for being quiet, though. I thought you were gonna talk, and then I'm gonna tell you to shut up again. But I was saying, okay, he is a very calm and quiet. He doesn't really smile or speak much, but is very polite. Oh, that's maybe why the story of him literally shows how beautiful manners he have, rather than Toby. Just, okay, remember the story we, read yesterday, okay? And then, to be honest... In my whole entire life, I've never made a long video. That was basically 3 hours long in the last video. Can you believe that? And the other one was kind of... It wasn't actually cut off or something. Because the other one was basically about, 10 minutes. Can you... Yeah, I don't know why you're being so quiet, though. That was, probably the longest video I've ever made. Literally reading the beautiful webpage story made by... Alicia the Wolf. So basically, you know, that's the... Wow, I respect her so much. She literally made a whole new content for me now because, I don't know, I have no content. I don't want to keep playing Among Us. I don't want to play Baldi. I don't want to play the baby in yellow. Literally, I'm sorry. I'm tired of playing all of their little games right now. I can't. But, basically, yeah, I can try if I do, but, can't believe Corey X Kenshin. He literally tried a lot. He's, similar to me. I couldn't actually beat Baldi. Neither can he, but suddenly he did. I don't know how he did that. I'm sorry. I'm so inspired, but I can't do nothing about it. Okay. Okay, where is it? But it is very polite. He is very apathetic. Yeah, I think apathetic. I don't know. Towards things that don't concern him. And he is a selfish egoist. Okay. And will always think of himself first. He judges anything by whether it benefits him or not. His parents treat him as a pet and a toy, so this caused him to become extremely repressed. Wait, it doesn't say depressed, it says repressed. I'm not sure what a repressed means, but... Okay, let me just see what it means, actually, because I can't. And the last time, I always forget how to literally search the meaning of this when I literally end the video. Okay, what does... there we go, mean? Sorry for literally recording a video, literally, I don't know. Okay, dictionary.
Repressed.
Oh, repressed. So I did actually say it right. Okay, trained, or... Yeah, I don't know. That didn't explain nothing. I do not know, but it's probably maybe similar to depression. I'm not pretty sure. Or maybe anger. I'm not sure. He doesn't show his appreciation to people unless somebody did it first. Then will be, receive protects. I don't know. He is very calculating of other people's deeds, but when But when a bigger benefit appears, he dares to betray. I'm sorry, why does it feel like I'm actually reading like a poem or something? This is actually beautiful, like a rhythm or something. He lacks gender and moral consequences. I think, yeah, consequences. However, he is still smart and manipulative. That's lovely. Okay, basically, he is a double-faced jerk with the front of a gentleman. Okay. And I thought he was like the calm or something. I don't know. As a criminal, he is extremely cautious, I think. I don't know. Of a criminal scene aesthetics. And every murder will be, what is it? Is it Me Too? I don't know how to say that. Sorry, it's too hard for me. Done like a piece of artwork. Oh, that's lovely. Okay. The mediums he used. Yeah, the mediums he uses and the methods he forces are extreme, making him a crazy artist. Oh, okay, that's a video? Wait, I'm sorry, should I watch the video or... Nah, you're actually mad. Look, I have no idea what to do, but yeah, oh, this is actually from YouTube. I thought this video isn't available anymore. What do you mean? What? I'm sorry, it doesn't work either. Okay, I don't even know. I literally, like, refreshed the page, but it didn't work. Okay. He basically has a... That's lovely. Okay, where is the others? I'm sorry, we saw Jason, didn't we? I'm sorry. No, that's the other, the popular creepypastas. Well, no, okay, let me just go back over here. This is the puppeteers one. He should be here. I'm sorry, where are they? I'm sorry, don't tell me I lost them right now. They were literally side. Wait. Oh, there we go. There's Jason, the toy maker. That's, yeah. What about Judge Angels? Okay, let me just see. Toy maker. Okay, so basically, yeah. Jason, the toy maker. Okay, I feel like I'm gonna create him. Or maybe the puppeteer. Yeah, I'm gonna actually create him first. Then the puppeteer. I don't know. He's, like, really funny. Like, what the freak? Look, shut up. Look, all I'm trying to say over here is that when I literally saw the voice line of him, he's really, like, sarcastic right now. He doesn't even care. Like, I don't know, whenever I search about their voice lines, every single time I see a little girl crying, or maybe a little baby or something, and I'm not pretty sure why. That's pretty, weird, but okay. Jason the Toymaker. Jason the Toymaker is a monster that appears in the creepypasta of the same name, Jason the Toymaker. He is a creature with human features who loves building and inventing toys. Okay, yeah, we can just say, like, we can just tell by his, name right now. Toymaker, okay. Origin. Jason the Toymaker is a creature with human features who loves building and inventing toys. He looks and acts like the perfect friend, but in reality, he's a selfish, lying, possessive, I think. Control freak. Who'll kill anyone he... What is this? Perceives as standing in the way of his goal. His goal is to convince the chosen. All his targets are mostly girls. Well, I'm sorry. Isn't that a fan? Sorry. Nah, are you mad? I'm sorry. Why do you laugh for no reason? Look at that. Literally, in the brackets, it basically says... Okay, in the brackets, it basically says all his targets are mostly girls. Well, that's lovely how we literally heard a little girl crying. To make a promise to play with him for all eternity, it doesn't matter to what extent, what is this? The Chosen keeps the promise because for Jason, the attention will never be enough. Okay, so that's like the little drawing thing right now. Oh, okay. Appearance. His design was changed back in 2016. His original coat and hat look is no longer canon. The one pictured above is. Oh, okay. Personality. He looks and acts like... Okay, so basically, they're like... I feel like... Okay, Laughing Jack, Laughing Jill, Pink Amina would be a best friends with Jason right now because all of them... I mean, Jason doesn't actually look like a clown, but... Let me just see something real quick. He looks more like a human, but dressed like a clown or something. I'm not pretty sure. Let me just see. Jason, the toy maker... No, Lily Canid. So, Lily Canid... I'm sorry, they're like... And their catchphrase is also the same as well. I'm not pretty sure what is Jason's catchphrase is, but Lily says, "Will you be my doll?" I'm not sure, because I actually thought, I mean, I don't actually, like, create dolls for my victims or something. I just randomly, like, what the freak? Are you serious? Look, yeah, I know how serious you look, but I am not. And of course, this is the drawing of my king right now. So, you know, I also have a monster form, if I didn't say that. Yeah, I don't know why you're all of a sudden you're being so quiet. Remember the picture I showed you of Amanda the Adventurer? You know, Amanda's monster form. Remember the monster that looks... I actually read her little description thing as well from the wiki of Amanda the Adventurer. So, she's basically like a monster, like an entity or something. Yeah. So, of course, it doesn't really relate to my, you know, thing right now. I wish I can explain, not by talking though, but... Yeah, that's Jason right there. I'm just gonna remove the Lily Cannon. So basically, yeah, she's maybe the same age as Sally, I'm not pretty sure. There we go, that's Jason right there. Wait, is this his original? Why does he have white? Now he basically has red hair. I don't know, let me just search something. Jason the Toymaker and Laughing Jack. Oh, Laughing Jack is really popular than these guys. Let me see. Laughing Jack. There we go. Oh, okay, there we go. Oh, that's lovely. What? Oh, that's Laughing Jack. Okay, I thought that kind of looks like, okay, Candy Pop. Oh, okay, so basically that kind of reminds me of Jill, though, like Laughing Jack, like the long hair at least. Like, Laughing Jack doesn't have that long hair. Look at that. Yeah, so basically, yeah, wanna play. I'm sorry, aren't you? And that's lovely how he basically has a dead girl's body. Okay, in his laps right now. That's lovely. Yeah, I'm gonna create Jason next, totally. I'm gonna create the puppeteer later, on Gacha Club. I literally have so many backup characters. This is lovely. Like, I literally respect Looney so much right now, because he literally, like, how do you say it? Recreated the game to make it more beautiful. Look at that. That's Candy Pop. Okay, so basically, yeah, Candy Pop doesn't actually have a gender, but most people in their, Gacha Club videos, they actually include her to be, like, a, how do you say it? Like a female clown, and not, like, a male clown or anything, but her voice line kind of sounds like a... She's basically a non-binary, in my opinion. I'm not pretty sure. What is this, I wonder? Well, that's lovely. I'm sorry, what is... Jason, did you... That's not Jason, though. Who is that? I'm sorry, what is... But yeah, I feel like they're gonna be, like, best friends right now. Okay, well, who... Okay, I don't know who the middle girl is right now, but, yeah, basically, that's cool, isn't it? You're actually mad. But as I was saying, okay, Oh, wait, he looks and acts like the perfect friend, but in reality, he's a selfish, lying, possessive... A control freak who'll kill anyone he perceives as standing in the way of his goal. He can't stand to be left alone. Oh my... I mean, not really. I mean, Laughing Jack... Okay, okay. He can't stand it when the center of attention moves away from him, and he hates it when the chosen proves to be ungrateful. When he understands the chosen can't keep the promise and wants to go away, Jason punishes them by transforming them into a wax doll so that they won't abandon him. Oh, that's a cool, wow, okay. Oh, this is Candy Pop, okay, let's go to her, I guess, yeah. I didn't, okay, basically, yeah, all of them are here, the Creepypasta Files Wiki, okay, Candy Pop. Dream while you're wide awake. Oh, that's like, wow, that's like, okay. Can you not every single time this thing take... Go away. Okay, thank you. I don't know, every single time I should join, like a different, okay. Okay, code from Candy Pop. Candy Pop is a creepypasta character that appears in the stories The Purple Balloon and The Darkest Truth. Oh, okay, I think, okay. Should I read this? Oh. Maybe, I'm not pretty sure, but okay, I'm just gonna read this. Origin. The original Candy Pop was a Ganner. What? Oh, okay, I cannot say none of these right now, but, like, yeah, this is Candy Pop. She actually is, like, most, how do you say it, drawn with, how do you say it, Jason right now. Oh, wait. Oh, this is, wait, I'm sorry, where's the other guy? The Kai, wait. Oh, there we go, this is the guy that I was talking about. Okay, what the, I'm sorry, this guy is actually Japanese. I'm sorry, they actually say something in Japanese. I'm not joking. I'm sorry, what is this? That's lovely. Okay, that's the translation version, in the brackets. Do you want to play? Code from... Oh, yeah, okay. I say, okay, is that... How do you say it? Is it Kagekayo? Yeah, Kagekayo is a demonic trickster who appears in the Creepypasta one... I mean, of the same name. Okay, yeah, there we go. Oh. I'm sorry, no way are you just... Look, I'm sorry, can I search up anyone else's right now? Oh, that is, Suicide Sadie. Oh, yeah, I'm also gonna make her as well. That's Offender Man, I'm sorry, what? Look, that is Judge Angel. Oh, yeah, Judge Angel, actually. Okay, yeah, basically, I wanna not actually read all of them, though. I wanna, like, keep on actually watching the other videos to actually, like, find out or something. Let's just search up Sonic.exe, okay. Because in here, when I search up something, it doesn't appear on the wiki. I don't know why. From Creepypasta. There we go. So, yeah, he is a Creepypasta once I search it up. There we go. I'm sorry, no way. Look, shut up. I'm sorry, does he actually have his own, like, thing right now? Yeah, there we go, finally. Okay, so, yeah, this is the wiki, everyone. Wow, this is, like, a cool-looking GIF. Like, you can see, okay, I'm sorry, are you serious? Yeah, this is your worst nightmare right now, Panda, so be prepared. shut up, I sorry, God. okay, what is this? Sonic.exe. I am God. Sonic.exe is the most famous code. Hello, do you want to play with me? That's lovely how every single time. Remember when Sally says something like, do you want to play with me or something? Like, you know. But okay, Sonic.exe is... Sonic.exe to Tails. You're too slow. Want to try again. Sonic.exe. Wait, I thought... No, that's actually from when he was actually, like, how do you say, tormenting Knuckles right now. I actually played the game, so I know. Okay, Sonic.exe, Sonic.exe, also known as X or X, I mean EXE for short, is the tutelar main antagonist of the Sonic.exe series. Sonic.exe is an Eldritch entity taking on the form of Sonic the Hedgehog that sends out a haunted game disc featuring the
It's basically the same as, how do you say it, Ben's. I mean, I actually want to be hacked by Ben, no offense. Like, I don't care what he did. I don't know why. I don't care what he does to my device. But, like, I really want to get hacked by him. But, okay. I already played Sonic.exe before, so I'm not going to, like, you know. Entity taking, okay. That sends out a haunted game disc featuring the creature killing the main Sonic characters. Oh, yeah, that's true. Eventually leading him to RIP. Is it RIP? Oh, yeah, okay, I mean, yeah, okay. Rip out the soul of his victim and making them his slave. Okay, now I know what you mean, because, yeah, you can, okay, yeah, okay. First story. The original Sonic.exe story centers on Tom. A young, okay, yeah, there you go. Same as, like, you know, the other person. I mean, I don't know how many backstories are there for Ben. Like, there was actually a 12-year-old boy named Ben. And there's the other one, you know, is it Judah Zelop? Judah Zelopel. Yeah, it's basically the person who maybe played the game, the Majora's Haunted, Majora's Mask game, I don't know. There's like so many details, I don't know. But it was saying, okay. On Tom, a young man who was a big fan of Sonic the Hedgehog, especially the older games. Oh, yeah, that's true, because I actually saw his backstory as well. Oh, yeah, I know. Okay, sorry, I don't know. He claimed that he had not played any glitchy or hacked games before, though he admitted that he didn't want to after an experience he'd had. Okay. He then proceeded to recount his experience, saying how he retrieved a CD and an accompanying, letter from his friend Kyle, begging him to destroy the disc before it's too late and not to play the game. Ignoring his friend's warnings, Tom played the game and began to encounter odd, somewhat disturbing phenomena from a title card featuring an evil-looking Sonic with bloody eyes and glowing pupils with a wide smile to the... it's the same thing. I cannot say it. I'm so sorry. Of a file secret screen similar to that of the one in Sonic the Hedgehog 3 with a red background and chilling music playing. Yeah, I know what happens, okay, I don't know. As he picked the only available character, Tails, and began the first stage. Did I click something? I don't even know what happened, but okay, begin to, what? Tails and began the first stage, titled Hill Act 1. Tom continued to find more evidence that there was something wrong with the game, mainly the copious amounts of dead animals, all murdered and gruesome. Yeah, gruesome ways, and eventually encountering Sonic at the end of the level. Oh, yeah, that's true, because, you know, yeah, encountering Sonic at the end of the level, standing completely still and with eyes closed. Oh, I know, he was actually, like, crossing his hands as well, like, arms. Okay, when Tails attempt to get his attention during a cutscene by tapping him on the shoulder. I mean, he doesn't actually do that, though. He actually doesn't, and when he basically gets a little closer to him, but then more kind of a glitching, distorted thing basically appears, and then Sonic basically opens his eyes, and you can see the, you know, Sonic.exe, okay. Tapping him on the shoulder, Sonic's eyes opened. I don't know why Panda's oddly staring at the ground, though. I told you, this is a warning for you. Get some headphones if you really are a big fan of Sonic, like Tom right now, the person who basically played the game. Okay, Sonic's eyes opened, identical to the Sonic on the title screen, before cutting to black, with the message, "Hello, do you want to play with me?" In the next level, hide and seek, Tom witnessed Sonic chasing Tails. That doesn't actually say letter. It says I think it's supposed to be later. I don't know. I don't know. What is this? I'm sorry. How do you actually spell this? I mean, let me just see. What does that actually mean? I'm just gonna have to get rid of that. There we go. So I have more pages open. Okay, there we go. I'm just gonna say what does. There we go. It doesn't matter. I don't have to put, like, there we go. Mean. Yeah, it's gonna come up right now. Oh, let me just gonna do something right, okay? Because this one. There. Yeah, I don't know why all of here. Okay, what is this?
Letter.
Oh, letter. Oh, yeah, basically. Oh. Oh, okay, okay, yeah, there we go. Now I know what it means. Okay, letter. Flying despite inability to do so without a super form before disappearing. Teleporting in front of the. Is it destroyed? I don't know. Fox. Oh. Oh no, okay. And killing him and cutting it to black. Shocked, Tom reads the next message. You're too slow. Want to try again? I feel like I want to, like, sound like him. I know, his voice is, like, really different. It doesn't sound like the old Sonic, like how he used to. It sounds so different. Now his voice gets more deeper and demonic. It sounds like, you're too slow. Want to try again? It basically says that. After playing as Knuckles and losing a supposed boss battle with Sonic, Tom decided to take a break from the game. However, his rest was plugged. Yeah, plugged by nightmares. By nightmares featuring the corrupted Tails. Oh no. Yeah, I know what happens. Okay, corrupted Tails and Knuckles and the demonic Sonic with him walking, with him waking in a cold sweat, returning to the game, Tom picked. I mean, if you literally encounter like a really odd disc in the situation, you would literally burn it or something, or destroy it, just like how Kyle said, one of Tom's friends right now, but he didn't. He still continued with the gameplay, okay. Where is it again? However, Tom picked a Robotnik from the file select screen and continued with the game. At the end of the level, Sonic teleported. At the end of the level, Sonic teleported in front of Robotnik before the screen cut to red static. Then, a hyper-realistic image of Sonic appeared on the screen with the words, "I am God." After the game ended, Tom turned around to find, to his utter horror, a blood-dead Sonic. It's basically the same, but, like, connected to each other. I don't know. A blood-dead Sonic plushie on his bed. Oh, no. Okay, sorry. Tom's fate is ambiguous or whatever. Yeah, ambiguous, I think. I don't know. Though the official sequel reveals that Tom committed suicide to escape from the entity using Sonic's likeness. That's lovely. Okay, second story. The sequel, prequel, I think, yeah, prequel of Sonic the EXE centers around a young detective named... That's lovely. I have never seen this before. Okay, not the video, though. Like, I think I'm reading a new story now. I don't know. Is it, yeah, Derek Green investigating the murderers committed by an unknown entity? Oh, we all know who that is. Okay, throughout the entire murder case, each murder has been investigated by Detective Derek Green and his sister. Is it Chelsea? Yeah, Chelsea. After Chelsea got captured by EXE, Derek was dropped out of the case for unknown reasons, but that didn't stop him from pursuing his sister's captor, as he secretly investigated each murder that EXE commits. Derek slowly becomes more and more paranoid to the point where he believes everyone is working for the cult through a mysterious contact named Cole. Derek discovered that the cult was behind the conspiracy that Chelsea was trapped in EXE's world. That's lovely. There's also like so many EXE games of Sonic, like the one, you know, Sally.exe, not the Sally from Sally Williams, you know, Sally, the one that's actually like a squirrel basically. And I think Sonic was in love with her, and he wasn't in love with Amy. There's also one with Amy, there's also one with Cream, the rabbit, and there's also one with Roach. I think Roach or something, I'm not pretty sure, but you know, conspiracy and that Chelsea was trapped in EXE's world. Speaking of Chelsea, do y'all actually remember? Yeah, I don't know why all of you are being so quiet, but you know, she's gone now, she'll never return back. And I can't believe I even created her thinking that how much of a spoiled brat she was, along with Candy. And I always thought that Candy was a nice and cheerful going person until... Yeah, I hope nothing bad happens. I don't know, but okay. I swear to God, look, that was an unexpected laugh from me. I did not expect that. But yeah, this is not actually my disguise form. This is actually my normal form. But like my monster or entity or whatever you want to call it kind of features the same as Amanda. And the monster, at least the design of the monster, but like I have a lot of details than her. Yeah, I want to actually create it so much, but I'm not pretty sure. You have to wait then. I'm not pretty sure. Look at that, Irma the Dolly. So that's my creepypasta name. I wish I was in these, like, how do you say, creepypasta files wiki right now. That would be amazing. I feel like a lot of people will love me as an OC. Like, this is actually not a different OC, like a different OC character I made. This is actually me as an OC from Creepypasta. So yeah, that's lovely, isn't it? So basically, what is this? EXE's world. Eventually, Derek got captured by the cult and comforted by one of the cult leaders. Is it Shannon Goldman? Yeah, I think that says, I don't know. Derek believed that by destroying the disc, which he did, that would once and for all stop EXE from tormenting humanity. But Shannon? Yeah, Shannon proved his effects pointless and revealed that the cult made multiple copies of the game disc in case anything happened to one of them. Is it Shannon? Yeah, Shannon then summoned EXE, who then proceeded to steal Derek's soul. 3 weeks later, after EXE stole Derek's soul, Derek's boss, Bob Richardson, received a message from Cole, who filled him in on what happened. Oh, so that's lovely, isn't it? How can you say this is lovely? I'm sorry, shut up, I swear to God. But yeah, this is all like Sonic's appearance. Should I read this? Yeah, okay. I mean, Sonic.exe is okay. Sonic.exe looks exactly like his idol, Sonic the Hedgehog, except there are several noticeable differences is his appearance. So EXE's fur and Cool's, I think, I don't know, are a darker blue Oh, yeah, I know what they mean by now. Yeah. I mean, it kind of... It looks like the same Sonic from the actual model, though. Like, maybe it's supposed to be, like the bloodstains that's making him, like, a more darker version. I'm not pretty sure, but, like, okay. Okay, I'm definitely not gonna make him. Oh, my God. What did you just say? Look, I'm gonna create every single creepypastas I know and all of those other famous OCs from the other creators, okay? Okay, differences, okay, are a darker blue and less smooth and more unkempt. Yeah, I think, I don't know. His skin a sickly pale color with a black color fading into his forearms, forearms. Oh, okay, I think, I don't know what, okay. Hands, forelegs, and feet symbolizing EXE's dark matter in a way, okay. His claws are sharp and pitch black, though sometimes they are also a bright purple. Oh yeah, I think, I'm not pretty sure, I didn't actually see him with purple hands though, but I'm okay. EXE's mouth is often, unnaturally wide when he smiles and is always fanged and yellow. Sir GC, JC, explained that the yellow on his teeth is not a result of tooth decay, but one of the few side effects when his body was first made. Okay, and his eyes are pitch black with two glowing red dots as irises with very little pupils. Okay, for some reason, EXE seems to always produce blood under his eyes even when he's not actually crying. Yeah, that's true. Look at Ben, for example. I'm sorry. The fact that he is basically drowned. Though this is a major birthmark. Well, that's lovely. I didn't know that. Wow, that's a cool-looking fun fact. Okay, major birthmark. When he was born, EXE's eyes hurt greatly. When EXE isn't crying blood, one can see a faint but noticeable rash under his eyes from crying so much blood. Oh, okay. Personality. Sonic.exe is the complete opposite of Sonic the Hedgehog. He is a worthful. So basically, it's all of, yeah, I can say that. It's a malevolent, sadistic, cruel, and twisted monster who takes glee in, yeah, so basically, that's all of the things right now. No way did you just read that. Look, shut up, as I was saying. This is Offenderman, one of Slenderman's brothers. That's... I don't know why this is, like, the first time actually doing something like a trigger warning. I'm sorry, no way. I'm sorry, you're too young for this. I'm sorry. Look, I am actually not. Shut up, I swear to God. I'm not sure if I'm gonna read this or not, but it looks fun to read, but, you know. I'm sorry, what? Look, there's also his other brothers as well. Let's go to the different one. Should we go to, Splenderman? Yeah, Splenderman, I think. Yeah, Splenderman. Splenderman from Creepypasta. I'm sorry, how? Look, this is why I'm telling you to keep on going. No, not that. Splenderman. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna get rid of that. It's gonna come here right now. What? I'm sorry, how did I actually spell it wrong or something? I swear I didn't. No. Yeah, I think, let me just do something. Splenderman. I'm sorry, this has gotta be a joke. I'm sorry, where, okay, let me just see. Slenderman's brothers. Okay, that's the only way I can do it right now. Okay. Slenderman's, brothers. Names. Okay, there we go. Yeah, there we go. Well, I'm sorry, what is this? The family consists of the great leader, Lord Zelgo. The two sons of Lord Zelgo, Slenderman and the... I'm sorry, this has to be a joke. I'm sorry, what? I'm sorry, ever since... I'm sorry, what is that? Did you see Zelgo's daughter? His biological daughter? His daughter right now. I'm sorry. Luzari is a literal human-like child. I'm sorry. I don't even know. Okay, Offenderman, okay, Trenderman... Okay, I don't get it. Where is Splenderman? You know the happy pasta. Where is it? Oh, there we go, finally. Who are Slenderman's brothers? Slenderman with his brothers. Oh, Splenderman. Oh, okay, I know what I did there, okay. Trenderman and Offenderman. There's also a different one as well, but I feel like that's like an OC maid or something, I'm not pretty sure. Okay, there we go. Finally, you're actually mad. Look, shut up, as I was saying. I'm just gonna search that up right now, copy and paste. I mean, there we go. Creepypasta. Yes, there we go. Okay, this is the fandom, right? Or wiki... I'm sorry, no way this is a thing. Look, so basically, yeah, there we go. So look at that. Splenderman, a.k.a. Splendy. Oh my god, okay, that's a lovely, okay. Is a happy pasta, which is a parody of the creepypasta genre, I think. Or genre, I don't know. He originated as a parody of Slenderman, but now fans like to portray him as a Slenderman. I mean Slenderman's nicer brother. He has since gained a massive amount of popularity in the Slenderman fan base. Yes, true. I'm sorry. Are you mad? Look, shut up. As I was saying, hey, origin. Slenderman first appeared in a Marble Hornets. Wait, did he? I'm sorry, this gotta be a joke. The fact that I literally watched half of the movie. Well, not completely though, but okay. Slenderman first appeared in a Marble Hornets parody from the YouTube channel. Naily, yeah, I don't know how to say that, but yeah, that's maybe a YouTube channel, I don't know. Where he was spotted by two very nice girls named Becky and Tiffany. Oh, Tiffany! Nah. I'm sorry, what did you just say? Look, that, okay, I did not mean to actually make anyone traumatized over here, but like, yeah, Tiffany, hello. How are you doing with your lovely doll family, along with Chucky and your lovely daughter, Glenda? Yeah, I don't know why you're still being so quiet, but okay, I did not mean to actually make her so quiet. I did not, okay? I don't know, is it because I look so scary? Okay, so basically, I feel like I'm gonna do something. So basically, there's like a meme, if you don't know. So basically, let me just go on YouTube right now. I'm sorry. Look, I'm gonna show you right now, okay? It's basically in my mouth. What did you... Look, in my mouth, it's basically like a meme. Look at that, there we go. But no, I'm just gonna put Jane the Killer. Okay, there, no, it's already here. Okay, so basically, look at that. So this is in my mouth animation meme, Jane the Killer. So basically, yeah, Jane never had this kind of design before, but like, that's her when she was wearing the mask. When she actually takes, yeah, there we go. So basically, you can see her mouth is kind of like cut open. Her mouth is actually cut open by the both of her cheeks right now and actually revealing her. I mean, yeah, so basically, yeah, you're actually mad. Look, so basically, I mean, I feel like my design is good, but like, you know how bloopers, how do you say, left side? His left side actually shows like a evil grin right now, you know? And also, I want to do the same, but I feel like I'm gonna like make myself have more cuts than usual, just like how this has. Yeah, I don't know why you're being so quiet, though. But yeah, this is actually, like, maybe an inspiration for me. Like, I just noticed, and I was like, wow, should I actually do this, or... And then maybe I will. Are you serious? Look, shut up, as I was saying. He then proceeded to give them flowers and dance for them in order to make them happy. Towards the end of the video, he threw glitter at them. Wait, he's not actually, like, a killer or anything, right? I'm sorry, what? Look, I know, he's actually a happy pasta. He basically said it, so you know. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have myself as a happy pasta or not, but like, you know. Are you serious? Look, I'm gonna say the appearance now because I have nothing to do right now. But as I was saying, okay, appearance. Unlike Slenderman, Slenderman has a visual face that consists of black dots for eyes and... I mean, originally... Yeah, look at his eyes are like kind of like a... upside down you or something, you will, you know. Yeah, where is actually? Okay, black dots for eyes and a black mouth. But he lacks a teeth. Oh, I did not know that. Okay, in most of portrayals, I think, yeah. And a nose. I'm sorry, what? I mean, maybe, oh yeah, that's, maybe on the side view, I'm not pretty sure. He also wears a black suit with a colorful polka dots. A bow tie are usually red, sometimes rainbow. Oh, okay. Yeah, most of the time it's basically rainbow color, so you know. and they telepath of varying sizes, or less commonly a triply hat. What is this? I'm sorry, you're actually mad. Look, shut up. As I was singing, hat, both seen with a red stripe. He is also very tall, like Slenderman, and his hands are black, with claws on the ends. On the ends of his fingertips. Wait, does he? Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay, he's actually wearing like black gloves, so you know. Oh, look at that. That's also the other brothers right now. I'm sorry. Look, shut up, as I was saying. So basically, I actually forgot to mention something. So basically, I was still on continuing with the creepypasta vines video I was making. And of course, I made 3 parts of it today. And it was amazing, not gonna lie. Like, literally, everything went so well. What did you just said? I'm sorry. Look, as I was saying, come on. Once you see the video, you're gonna keep on seeing it over and over again, trust me, because of how funny it is, okay? I literally work like hours, probably like weeks or months right now to literally, I'm not even finished with it though, I have to like do more of it, you know? And how long is that video gonna be? Look, I do not know. I don't even know, because I'm actually making it on Kindmaster, so you know. Fingertips, contrary to the Slenderman's normal looking bare hands with lack of claws, although his skin is usually portrayed as being the same shade as most, is it Kosciuszko's? I don't know. He has been portrayed as being just as pale as his brother, and he is often shown to have rosy cheeks. Oh, isn't that so adorable? Nah, you're actually, look, I wanna make all of them if I have more backup characters, okay? So, you know. But although, I'm gonna start making Jason, so, you know. I'm sorry, what is going on? I'm sorry, what is, what the, Slenderman video by, oh, nah, I'm sorry, this is actually, I'm sorry. A few weeks ago, okay, I have to, like, literally zoom this thing. Although it keeps showing this thing, though, okay, get away, okay, there we go. I don't know, I literally put the thing full screen right now, but, you know, okay, yeah, that's a Slenderman, the title, of the video. A few weeks ago, we attempted to shoot a short film. Oh, so it's basically kind of the same as, how do you say, Marble Hornets then. Okay. Does it have volume? I mean, it does, but it has no sound, okay. But when we got the news, when we got the footage back, there was clearly something very wrong. Oh, you may have spotted one of Slenderman's brothers then. Okay. Something we could not explain. Okay. Here is the footage we managed to take. Okay. So yeah, it did actually show 2 girls right now, so okay. So the thing wasn't actually... You thought. Look, I did not think it would lie. Oh, come on. I wanna like watch the video to find out. Oh, it does have volume now. Also, these 2 girls, this could be Becky and Tiffany then. Yeah, they're actually having a normal picnic in the woods, I think, I don't know. Let me just, oh, that's lovely, girls. Okay. What did you just say? Look, shut up, it's about to happen now. It's gonna happen. it's gonna literally come now.
It's a beautiful day. I know, thank the Lord. I'm glad to be here with you, eating this sumptuous strawberry, celebrating friendship. Mm-hmm. I have
enough. Well, that's lovely. Oh my, I'm sorry guys, I just literally saw kitties. Look, I actually saw kittens, I'm sorry. It was like a distorted looking static, but then suddenly I just saw little kittens. I'm sorry, I know what is this. Because he's actually a happy pasta, he's not a creepy pasta. He doesn't actually kill anyone though, because you know.
What are your views on politics? I support everybody because I think it's nicer. I support
people. Oh my god, I just saw something. It's not really creepy though, it's kind of happy. Like, I saw like a, how you say it, like, what do you call those things? Like, literally go up, like a floaty or something. I forgot what it's called, but like, wait, what else did I saw? And capture. Oh, I saw ice cream. What the frick? Look, shut up. I know how confused you look. It's probably because you don't read any neither of the creepypastas or the happy pastas. As I was saying.
Hey.
Wait, what did you say?
Hey.
Oh.
Yeah, me too. Hey. Yeah, me too. Hey. Hey, Grandma.
Hey.
It's me and Becky.
Like, oh, yeah, so that is Becky. Oh, so that's maybe Tiffany. Okay.
You gotta have your surgery, okay?
Yeah, we're really, really happy to...
And we can't wait to see...
I'm sorry, where is Splendorman? I'm sorry, where... I wanna see him so bad. I wanna see... I don't wanna see these girls talking. Okay, well, okay, fine.
Hey, Grandma.
Hey.
It's me and Becky.
Glad you gotta have your surgery, okay?
Yeah, we're really, really happy to...
And we can't wait to see you again.
Yeah, we're on vacation right now, but we'll be home really, really soon.
Yep, see you, Grandma.
Bye, Grandma. I love you.
Oh my god, guys, I just saw something so beautiful. What the freak? Look, I feel like they're sisters, are they? Because they keep saying grandma from the surgery right now, so, yeah. I'm sorry, what the freak is this? Look, shut up. That's what I'm saying. Oh my god, oh my god, look at these cute looking rabbits, guys. Yeah, I'm so happy. They're not covered with blood or anything. Because whenever you say something so happily... Everything is so gory and blood. I'm sorry. Look, so this isn't. Look at that. There's like pink flowers around them. Oh my god, look at these rabbits. They're so cute. I'm sorry, what is... What's I was saying? What?
Imagine if we saw...
Oh my god.
That would be so cool.
I know. Oh my... Air balloon? Wait, air balloon? I'm sorry, I think those things are actually called air balloon. Oh my god, I can actually see Splendorman right now behind. Nah, look, he's a happy pasta, so I'm gonna talk about everything happy, okay? But as I was saying, wait, air balloon, let me see. There we go. So maybe, oh, there we go. Oh, so these are air balloons. Oh, so those are the things that I was talking about to you guys earlier, because I didn't know the name, sorry. Oh my god, can I see him behind?
Imagine if we saw a hot air balloon.
That would be so cool.
I know. Maybe one's behind that cloud over there.
Oh, we can only hope.
Let's keep watching.
Yep.
You feel weird?
Yeah, that's a little strange. Do you feel something?
I'm sorry, what the f- I'm sorry, and I am so happy these girls are not scared of him. Look at that. I'm sorry, this is- Oh my god.
Splendorman!
Aww. Oh my god. Look at that. They're all laughing right now. Aww. Oh. What Splendorman and editing. Oh, that was lovely. So, because I thought they, when the thing said that he initially threw, like, glitter at them, I thought they were gonna die or something. But, yeah, then I realized that he's actually a happy pasta, so, you know. That was lovely. I like that. You're actually tripping. Look, shut up. I'm sorry. I want to see, like, more, like, actual, like, action videos right now. Like, you know, real life. Yeah. No, let me just go to Trenderman. Yeah, don't you even dare. Look, fine, I won. Okay, I don't even know what's going on, but... that was lovely. Or if I did actually... There we go, that's Trenderman. I'm sorry, I don't... Is there, like, a video of him as well? I'm sorry. Look, shut up. As I was saying, okay, I wanna feel, like, read the origin, though, to literally find out before there's, like, an actual video about it. Okay, Trenderman. Trenderman is a meme and a spin-off of the Slenderman. Unlike Slenderman, he is not a myth, but instead... I mean, what? But intended as a parody. All of them are, I'm sorry. Okay, oh, that thing is literally... Wait, what the... Oh, no, that's just a thing. Okay, that's nothing. Okay, origin. The origins of Trenderman can be traced back to Tumblr, user, conjured, Chrisma, who, on July 31st, 2012, took a pictured photograph and... posted it on his blog under the title Slenderman's Casual Friday. Oh, okay. However, the Trenderman name and the other character's further relationship as a relative of Slender Man were coned on August 1st of the year by Tumblr user I like tact. Oh, okay. As a response to another user commenting on the photo. Oh, okay. Appearance. Trenderman looks somewhat like his cousin, Slenderman. I'm sorry, don't tell me they're cousins. Or are they supposed to be, like, brothers? I don't know, but okay, yeah, it's similar, I guess, I don't know. But with a brown sweater, sometimes portrayed as a sweater vest, a wide undershirt, and brown pants. His skin is also darker than Slender Man's. Why is it, like, separated? Isn't it supposed to be, like, together? But, okay, I don't know. Being between his wide and a normal human tan skin. I mean, sometimes, not really. If it still looks like a pale white. Oh my god, that's lovely. let me just see something again. Okay. Hey, that's true. I mean, sometimes they actually, like, no, most of the time I see, like, Splendor Man actually having, like, a normal human skin color. Not like his other brothers, though, but okay. In some pictures, however, he is just as pale as his cousin. Oh, there we go, finally. Okay. His clothes also change sometimes. Oh, since a fashionable person can't wear the same outfit outfit all the time. Oh, that's lovely. Fans usually depict him with wide tentacles. Some fans have also taken to drawing him with glasses. Oh, that's lovely. I feel like doing that, to be honest. Like, I don't know why I feel like being, like, in the olden days right now whenever Creepypasta started and, like, you know. Personality. He is often portrayed as a drama queen who cannot stand people who go for the swag look or who wear Crocs. Okay. He also is shown as somewhat self-absorbed due to his fashion sense. He often becomes overly, I don't know how to say that, sorry, about helping others find better outfits so that others can become more fashionable. I'm sorry, why am I literally laughing while reading this? Like, I'm not sure, like, I'm sorry, it's your human body, it's your soul, it's your, look, shut up, did I ask for your opinion? Like, why are you always the one who have to talk, like, literally, why can't, wow, that was so unexpected. Who said that? Oh, look at that. Will you look at that, I mean? That's Draco. That's lovely. What made you talk in a long time? And I thought you were gonna be quiet like the others have. Oh, trust me. I don't know, since I've been initially repeatedly watching your other videos, finding how psycho you are, and I thought you were the most nicest. I mean, come on, look at you. Although you have that carved mouth around your cheeks right now, on the left side of your cheek, but who cares, really? I'm sorry, I didn't really care about your health conditions a long time ago, but, like, now I actually think you're a psychopath. Along with that robot thing, that robot rabbit thing down there, that looks exactly like Monokuma from Danganronpa. You look exactly the same copy as Junko Inoshima, but different color schemes and more details. I'm sorry, what is this? Yeah, I don't even know what happened. You just literally randomly laughed out of nowhere, and now you're saying, what is this? I don't know, but okay, whether this is because of a need to help others or intolerance, I don't know, for what he perceives. Okay, perceives as unfashionable, unfashionable outfits are left up to his, to interpretation, I think, I don't know. Trenderman is sometimes portrayed trying to convince Slenderman to wear something more fashionable. I'm sorry, isn't that so adorable? Brotherly. What did you just said? Look, literally, they're all brothers. What do you expect? I wanna feel like reading Offenderman's, but it's gonna be a bit. And I'm not sure if our channel is gonna be a kid-friendly, because, you know, you have to be, like, over 13 or over 18 to see that, or, like, if you're, like, an adult or something, then, like, a teenager, okay? I don't know why it happened to me. laugh even louder. I'm sorry, what is this? The fight is actually getting dark right now. Look, do I look like I care? Like, literally. Mazu was saying, okay. Power and abilities. It is unknown if he has any special abilities other than his neat fashion sense, though some portray him with tendrils on his back like his cousins, mainly white ones, like sexual and offender one. What did you just say? Look, they also realized how like Slenderman and also Splenderman basically have the same black tentacles. But Offenderman and Trenderman has like white tentacles, okay? Isn't that so amazing? I'm sorry, what the freak? Look, shut up, as I was saying, okay. Look, there is Offenderman that's... I don't know where there you go, Slenderman, yay! You are actually mad. Look, as I was saying, who should I do? Slenderman or Oh yeah, let's go to Slenderman. Our beloved character, I love him, oh my god. Literally, he's like in all single movies. He's like, oh, so popular. He also has his own games right now. Isn't that so amazing? Okay, oh my god, is this actually a catchphrase from him? Okay, let me see. Okay, Slenderman. We didn't want to go. We didn't want to kill them. But it's a persistent silence and outstretched arms. Horrified and comforted us at the same time. Aww. Oh, Slendy. Oh my god. What the freak? Look, shut up. This is, like, everyone can call them whatever you want. Oh, so are you gonna call me Offendy or something? Yeah, I don't know why all of you are just staring behind me right now, but I know who that was. That was Offenderman. I know who that was, okay? Mezzo was saying, I don't know why Slenderman and all his other brothers are just oddly staring at him. Okay, Mezzo was saying, what is this? Caption from the original Slenderman post on the something awful. Oh, okay. Is it from, I don't know how to say that, sorry. The Slenderman is a widely popular internet urban legend, horror icon, and very commonly the tutelar main antagonist of many stories involving him. Oh my god, Slendy. I'm not pretty sure though. Like, it's gonna be my own story and it's gonna be something way different than other creepypastas' backstory, so you know. Okay, Slenderman is a humanoid creature with a vast, array? I think, so basically, when I was doing PE a long time ago, we were actually doing rounders, mind, and I was actually outside. I was actually sitting down, pretending that I actually batted 2 times. I was actually talking to my friend Shaylee and saying that, do you know the creepypastas? She said, yeah, she does, and I said, who do you know? She actually started saying Jeff the Killer. Or something. I'm not pretty sure. I asked her like a lot of. Yeah, he also said like a. She also said like a elf. And I was. I excitedly said, that's Ben Drowned. And then then she said, yeah. Or something. I'm not pretty sure. And then I said Slenderman at the end. And then she was like, okay. I don't know what happened next. I literally forgot about some memories. But you know. No wonder why you have a memory loss. He is so perfect. What do you say, masky and hoodie? I'm so sorry, I'm just asking my opinion. You gotta agree with me, though. But as I was saying, I don't know what's going on over here, but as I was saying, okay, is it Arve? I don't know. Of supernatural powers and abilities. Well, why can't he be real? I'm sorry, can you please take me? I'm sorry, I actually wanna be in your mansion. I wanna kill people for all of the thing I want. Like, I don't know why, because I feel like I'm on the internet too much. And I think I need to touch grass, no offense, because I've always on the internet watching horror stuff or like creepypasta memes and involving Slendy in it. I literally want him to literally somehow come into my dreams, haunt me in my dreams or something. Then suddenly I just woke up in his mansion. I want something like that. Initially growing up to be a killer, oh, that would be amazing. Like, I can just imagine all the stuff going around. But as I was saying, I don't know why all of you are just staring at me though, but as I was saying, okay, supernatural powers and abilities, his most common hobbies include kidnapping children and brainwashing innocent people with becoming his proxies. Oh, Slendy! So are you gonna be his proxy or what? Actually, no, really, because Blooper is one of my OCs. He's kind of similar to Monokuma, if I didn't say that. He basically is the same opposite of Monokuma. He's basically like a a rabbit, like a rabbit demonic robot, but has more details in him, more than Monokuma. So, you know, he's basically the one who kind of brainwashed me and basically made me, like, I don't know, into his little, under his influence or something. Similar Slenderman, but, like, you know, he's like the, how do you say it, like the headmaster of the Hope's Peak. No, I mean, I don't know what to create for my own, like, little... Yeah, I don't know why, I just don't know, but okay. Okay, let me just see. Abilities, his most common... Yeah, I already read that. Innocent people into becoming his proxies. Due to his popularity, Slenderman has been seen as one of the most famous urban legends and horror icons of the internet. Oh my god, Slendy. Okay, basic description. Oh, this is something different. Okay, I've never seen this before, but okay. The Slenderman is a supernatural creature with nebulously, defined characteristics and abilities. In almost every, in almost every description of the Slenderman, his attributes, attributes will vary. Vary sometimes greatly. However, his basic appearance and traits are relatively consistent across different accounts. He generally appears in modern times as a tall humanoid creature in a black or gray suit. I mean, it's mostly, yeah, basically the same, black or gray, because some people actually draw him, like, having, like, a totally black suit, or sometimes in the, like, the model versions, his suit is basically, like, gray, so, you know, red or black tie. Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay, yeah, I was, like, red. He doesn't never wear a red suit, but okay, I literally thought that, but okay. Red or black suit, black tie, most of it, yeah, it's basically the same. Yeah, okay, and white shirt, his face is totally white, completely devoid of facial features, he has no hair, and generally has normal-looking bare hands, with fingers longer and boner, bonier, I think, yeah, than a typical, typical human, okay. Slenderman has been depicted in imaginary and literature. Yeah, I think I said that right. I don't know. And anywhere between 6 and 10 feet tall, depending on the situation. Though in a video, he is usually only around 6 to 7 feet tall. Okay. He behaves in what might be seen as a passion. Aggressive manner, often stalking targets for years at a time before ever attacking. It's understood that he tends to torture his targets mentally over long periods of time, using fear and paranoia to drive them to insanity. No one has ever explained the reasoning behind his tactics or the way he chooses his victims and his purposes and or motivations have yet to be fully trained. Oh, okay, I don't know. He is rarely if ever portrayed in a good or beginning, light, and is generally understood to be a, so the same thing as the other one that we read. Oh, I think, yeah, it's the same as, when we read Sonic.exe's, okay, malevolent force, okay, that's a lot. I'm sorry. Look, you thought I'm gonna read all of this? No, I already know what happened to Slendy, so, you know, he actually has a backstory. Look, he doesn't. Because in some of... Look, I did saw the actual backstory of his, and he's just, like, somewhat real in the situation. I'm not pretty sure, but, like, you know. That's Jeff the Killer, that's Offender Man. Yeah, I think he's the last one we have to go over, or... What did you just said? But I was saying, okay, I don't know. This is, like, the only trigger warning this has. I'm sorry, what happened? Look, fine, I'll stop acting so weird. I'm not sure I like this, but okay. okay. Should I read this? Okay, yeah, okay, okay, yeah, sure. Offender Man is a spin-off of the Slender Man. Unlike Slender Man, he is not a myth, but instead, I mean, intended as a parody. He is a user of a woman, a rapist, possibly, I don't know how to say none of that. What is it? Is it a zoo pail? I don't know. Nah, you're actually, I'm sorry, what is going on? Am I gonna shiver and... I'm sorry, was that Draco? Look, they're finally talking in a long time. Be grateful that I don't have to speak to them. But as I was saying, okay, this is his origin right now. Oh, I cannot wait to watch these. Not today, though. I don't know. In comparison to Slender Man, Sexual Offender Man is more urban-based, often hanging around closer to towns and cities than Slender Man. Ah, so they basically have their own little stories. Okay, who typically sticks to forests is not quite clear if this is because he doesn't get along with Slender Man and seeks to avoid him, or if he simply just wants to be closer to where people are. Maybe it's a little of both. Also, unlike Slender Man, Offender Man tends to target teenagers, and adults rather than young kids. Yeah, that's true. That's true. I know what they're talking about. What did you just say? Oh, look, I'm gonna cut my video in a minute after I literally read all of this, so you know, because my look at my charge. How many? Oh, that's lovely. I have 15%. Oh, okay, there we go. I don't know. As I was saying, I'm gonna keep reading this, and once I finish reading this, then I'm gonna, like, you know, cut the video. But as I was saying, okay, yeah, where was it actually again? Oh, wait. Oh, also like Slenderman. Okay, okay. Oh, yeah, adults rather than young kids. Is it interactions with young kids are usually limited to participating in acts of the juvenile, I don't know, delinquency, which as smashing mailboxes, setting things on fire, huffing paint, and generally, getting them out of their parents, or older siblings' hair long enough to have a wild without having to deal with any screaming kids trying to call the cops. I just did not read that word. Just because I don't know if my video is gonna, like, get demonetized or deleted from YouTube, I don't know. But, genuinely, what the freak did I just saw with my eyes? Look, shut up. As I was saying, I'm pretty sure everyone did. Look at all of the other few, like, four new OC guests of mine. They're all just staring at my Chromebook. I'm just not gonna, but as I was saying, okay, I don't really care if it's getting dark. I'm almost done recording this video anyways, but as I was saying, generally, encounters with Offender Man play out like this. The victim will be alone, where they will meet a tall man hidden in the shadows, well enough for them not to be able to entirely make out his features. I'm not sure if I said that right, but okay. The man will offer them a rose. If the rose is accepted, regardless if they understood its meaning, they will be, is it, whisked away and molested, I don't know, by Offender Man then wake up someplace else, often somewhere embracing, without any memory of the event. Oh, okay. They will experience slender sickness for a time with effects of it varying, from person to person, the effects can range anywhere. I love reading this though, like literally. I still kind of hate reading, but like this is fun. Like literally, oh my god. Okay, oh, I did not mention to piss that. Okay, there we go. The effects can range anywhere from an awful hangover to a stomach bug to a rash to the standard nosebleeds, coughing up blood. The only real similarities as far as side effects go being having erotic nightmares involving someone resembling him. Not all return though, since no bodies have ever been found. It's unknown what he does to those specific victims. He is perfectly capable of murder. If they do not accept the rose, he will stalk and harass them for a short while, doing everything from downloading a bunch of Okay, I'm not gonna read that out. You know what it is. Just go and search up on the offender man from the Creepypasta Wiki and you can just read it by yourself. I'm not gonna say that word. Okay, onto their computer and stacking a living room. Is it Fortuner? I don't know what that says, sorry. When they're not looking, to leaving dead animals in their bathtub and appearing for split seconds in the corner of their eye. Eventually, he'll trick the victim into following a trail of rose petals to whenever he is and will. You can guess the rest. Okay, that's all. It just says dot dot dot, does it? Yeah, it says dot dot dot. Okay, Offenderman original video, original voice. Well, that's lovely because there's like so many of them. Not lying. This is Nina, everyone. Although I didn't actually like read her stuff. Yeah, look at that. She started as I'm not gonna read it though, I'm just saying the top lines, okay? Then I'm gonna cut the video. Look at all these little cute looking Among Us characters just floating around. Okay. Nina the Killer or Nina Hopkins. Go to sleep, my prince. Okay, yeah, it basically says, go to sleep, my prince. Like that, so basically, I'm not sure. she started as a normal fangirl of Jeff. So, you know, yeah, I'm sorry. And I thought she was the most psychopathic yandere. The most psychopathic in this room. And it looks like I was wrong. I did not expect you to... What is this? I'm sorry, what did Draco just say? In a long time, I thought I'm never gonna, like, talk to them ever since. Rocky, Jack, and Overquill. You also removed Overquill? I'm sorry, how much of a bad person are you? Look, I needed new characters. I cannot just stick with the old characters, do I? Like, literally. What does that say? In Female Teenager spin-off and 10 more. That's lovely. Okay. are you serious? What is this? Look, but as I was saying, okay, so basically, yeah, this story is kind of, like, based on her and her little brother, anyway, so, you know. I'm just gonna cut the video over here, so, you know, I hope you enjoyed. I don't know why everything's so dark here, though, like... And I thought you said you liked the dark. Look, I did! And I don't know, but sometimes I do turn off the lights and turn off the lights, so, you know. Should I read this? I still have more time, do I? Nah. Literally lied to our faces. Look, I swear to God, I did not. I don't know. I can't find no one else. Although I do not read them more, but I don't know. I'm sorry, are you... What is this? This one is so much better than the 2021 version, man. Yeah, oh God. This is exactly why I have lost faith in the humanity. What are you talking about? All these are comments. Oh, she's cute. Is it weird that I'm 16 and her age is probably 16 as well? Okay. Although this may seem unpopular, I think this is better than the improved version, and the creator should have stayed with the crazy in-love fangirl concept rather than just making another Jeff ruined my life, now I want revenge, Jane the Killer clone. Oh, yeah, because they actually, like, rebooted her character right now. She used to be, like, a crazy fangirl version of Jeff, but, like, now they actually made her, like, maybe, like, a smoke addict or something. She doesn't actually fall in love with Jeff anymore, doesn't actually act like she actually loves him or anything, like, you know. Wait. It could be the same, I'm not pretty sure. No, it just shows the old Nina picture, so, yeah. So, I'm not pretty sure. Let me just go down. I like reading some of the comments, though. Okay. Nina is totally obsessed with Jeff, bruh. Okay, there we go. That's lovely. Nina is totally obsessed with... Oh, yeah, I already read that. Wait, it's the same thing. What was this? Nina is totally obsessed with Jeff. That's lovely. This shouldn't be in the canon pastas list. I understand how the killer is... Okay, so basically, that's lovely. You're actually... Wait, what is this? I agree with you. Okay, that's basically, like, replying to this comment. So I did not read the comment, though. Should I? is overused, that, I mean, yeah, I'm gonna read it anyways. Overused, but Nina was literally made to be a Jeff the Killer fangirl. I don't see anything wrong with it. Just because you don't like her doesn't rude. What? Doesn't rude about it. Oh, okay, you can't hate on anyone who makes a creepypasta based off another. Why aren't you guys hating on Laughing Jill or Jane the Killer? She's a Jeff the Killer. I mean, she's a Jeff fangirl wannabe. That's the point. Yeah, that's true. I think all these people are talking about her rebooted design because her, you know. Oh, that was in October 10th. I mean, it was basically like this reply was commented on the 10th of October in last year, in 2022. I agree with you. I think it's funny seeing people complain that Nina is a Jeff copycat when the whole point of Nina is that she tries to, emulate Jeff, and that concept can actually work in some ways on its own. A serial killer is terrifying, but someone who loves them and wants to replicate them is even scarier. It would be, okay, basically, I'm sorry for little stopping because it just says dot dot dot, so, you know, I was just trying to, like, follow along with that. It would be great if Nina could be improved in a few ways, though, such as not having her backstory exactly like Jeff's and maybe changing the whole 2007 emo scene kid. What is this kid with kid look with something a little more, I don't know what that, yeah, is it, yeah, particle, I think, yeah, particle, and then Nina would actually be more interesting. This is a bad fanfiction, pretending it's anything, but, wow, that's lovely, off-brand Jeff the Killer, she's literally not. Everyone says, I didn't know that this actually has, like, a comment section, but okay. Why does she hate clockwork? There are so many facts without any cited source. I don't know, wait, does that actually say anything like that? I don't know, you're actually mad. Look, fine, I'll cut the video over here, like, literally. Oh, I just realized. Yeah, actually, no, wait, I'm just gonna do something real quick. I'm sorry, what? What is that? And the creepypasta, oh yeah, that's basically a different language. I do not know what that says. Wait, it's actually English. Let me see. I'm sorry, you're actually... Oh no, that's not. Okay, sorry. It's just literally a different language. You're actually... Look, shut up. But as I was saying, okay, yeah, everyone's from different languages right there, okay. Oh, medicine. Meme. Oh, creepy. Oh, I know that meme, maybe. I don't know. Yeah. What is this? Tangen's bird is popular for a... Oh yeah, that's true. From Demon Slayer. Yeah, to be honest, I feel like Demon Slayer is more favorite of mine now. I don't like My Hero Academia anymore, I don't know why. Oh yeah, this meme, I know this meme. Wait, is that Toby or is that Masky? Wait, I think it's both. Oh. All of their eyes are just the operator's symbol right now. What? Look, the operator symbol is basically like the circle that has a cross in the middle, and that's actually the operator symbol. It's not the creepypasta logo symbol, but the same as that. So, you know. What? What's the thing? Oh, that's Tim, or like Masky. That's Brian and Hoodie, you know, the same person. That's Toby. Who is that? Wait, I'm sorry, who is this? And I thought this was like Kate the Chaser. What? Oh, that's Kate the Chaser. Yeah, okay. I don't know who the other people are. Wait, is this the rake? I don't know. Huh. It's lovely, though. I wish I could animate them, though. Like, okay. What is this?
The Demon Slayer's crows just have so much lore around them, letting me know that Gotouge was having fun with these characters. Like, did you know that Tanjiro's crow was named Tanoji Matsumon, and that he considers Tanjiro his disciple instead of considering himself a pet, which hints at his abrasive personality, which hides a warm and comforting core, much like Tanjiro has.
That's lovely.
Grateful to Tanjiro is Kanao's crow, Isuzu, who at first was secretly worried about Kanao because she couldn't express herself or live the way she wanted, but the bird is too shy to thank Tanjiro for helping her out of her shell, making it not that far off from Kanao herself.
Oh.
As we recently discussed, Muichiro's crow is named Ginko and it treats Tokita like it's his mother despite not getting along with other crows, but the opposite can be said for Tengen Uzui's crow, Nijimaru, who expresses himself flamboyantly, much like his master, and is so dripped out that apparently he's become a fashion icon in the crow world. Crows have fashion icons.
That's lovely. Oh, so that was actually a lovely story. I actually understand all of it, though, like, literally. Because I literally watched Demon Slayer, but not all those seasons, though, but, you know. I'm sorry, what was that? Look, that was the Demon Slayer crows right now, okay? Now shut up. As I was saying, can I adopt them? That's lovely, Shinobu. I'm okay. Nah, you're actually mad. What is this? I'm sorry, look, but as I was saying, so basically, yeah, I'm just gonna cut the video over here because I don't have that much percent charge anymore. Oh, 12 right now. What is this? Look, but as I was saying, oh no, that's nothing, okay? My favorite anime ship. Yeah, I'm not gonna even talk about it. I think it's gonna include Bakudeku in it, so. Wow, you totally hate them now, do you? Look, I always thought that Deku was a nice and kind boy in My Hero Academia, but I feel like he's a... I'm sorry, you feel like he's a what now? Look, I feel like it's gonna make you more sad because he's your favorite character anyway, so I'm not gonna say it. I know what she was about to say. And she even told me that your favorite character is Deku, so it's gonna make you really shocked and probably traumatized if... I'm sorry, what did you just said? Look, I am her new OC. I've been literally made by her for like a few weeks, actually. My name is Draco the Dragon. I don't want to actually say nothing about this because I feel like this is gonna like make you more traumatized if I did not mean to actually make you say that. I'm so sorry. Wait, what is this? Michiro's bird can survive. What?
Everyone has a sad backstory or ending, and as you've already seen, this even extends to their special birds. Previously, we've discussed how the Kasugai crows are all raised by...
Yeah, Kasugai. So basically, yeah, Kasugai crows are basically the birds. I mean, the crows in, like... Yeah, they're basically the trainer's crows, so, you know.
Amane, but they have their own personalities and lives, and even have a sort of society amongst each other.
Aww. Okay, so that was actually Chuntaro. You know Chuntaro from Demon Slayer. That is actually Zenitsu's bird, okay?
Ginkgo, which he likely named himself after the ginkgo trees that surrounded his mountainside home, which is just another sign of Tokito's memories leaking out. Ginkgo, just like Muichiro Swordsmith, is actually really worried about the Mist Hashira and dotes on him a lot like a mother bird. And the two remain close because Ginkgo
does
not love other crows. However, when Tokito dies during the battle against Upper Moon 1, the bird loses a ton of weight and needs to be nursed back to health, which Tanjiro's crow does, allowing the two birds to fall in love and even get married.
If you know, all the Hashiras basically, how do you say it, slowly dies by fighting the upper ranks or the lower ones. Upper rank 1. Wait, upper rank 1. Wait, what? Let me just see something again.
Sad backstory or ending.
Kind of like... Okay, I cannot actually fast forward it, okay.
...extends to their special birds. Previously, we've discussed how the Kasugai crows are all raised by Ubi Ishiki and Amane.
Yeah.
But they have their own personalities and lives, and even have a sort of society amongst each other. Muichiro Tokito's bird is named...
I didn't know. I was like, this could be probably, like, based on the season 3, if I'm actually sure. Wow, I like the crow's eyes. Yeah, it's actually a girl crow. Like a female crow, okay.
...that surrounded his mountainside home, which is just another sign of Tokito's memories leaking out. Ginkgo, just like Muichiro Swordsmith, is actually really worried about the Mist Hashira and dotes on him a lot like a mother bird. And the two remain close because Ginkgo doesn't get along with other crows. However, when Tokito dies during the battle against Upper Moon 1...
Upper Moon 1, okay, let me just see. Upper Moon 1. Don't tell me it's... I'm sorry, it's him. I'm sorry. Okay, basically, yeah, this is the... is it Kakashi... Yeah, I mean... Kokushibu. Yeah, Kokushibu is the upper rank one. Yeah. It's probably in the... How do you say it? In the mangas, if I'm right. I don't know. Yeah, this is the demon that has, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Yeah, 6 eyes, basically. I'm sorry. Look, I like Demon Slayer, and Demon Slayer is probably my favorite. My favorite out of all in the situation. I like the whole lore and all the backstories, and Nezuko-chan as well. Yeah, Demon Slayer is totally my best. You're literally gonna leave. Mirko, are you? Wait, who keeps talking? Oh, it's you, Draco. Oh, you were the one who's talking. Okay. And I always thought that it was gonna be... That's lovely. Okay, I don't know why... Yeah, it looks like... looks like Panda's still being quiet after that. Okay. But yeah, basically, yeah. Oh, this is them as Roblox versions. That's lovely. Yeah. Kind of similar to their faces, though. Yeah. But in like a Roblox body shape and face type. Yeah. Okay, so... Oh, that's Tanjiro. So basically, yeah, of course, I know. I'm not pretty sure because Mirko, she is the pro hero after all. And yeah, I do have my liking to her, but like, not really much. She just acts like she's really popular and everyone loves her or something. So I don't really... Yeah, I don't know why you're being so quiet right now, Draco. But okay, what is this? Why isn't that lovely? Upper rank demon trailer. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm gonna spoil myself, so I'm not gonna watch that, sorry. But I'm sorry, this is Sailor Moon. What is this? Shin Obi, Sailor Moon, upper rank of, I mean, upper moon one. That's lovely. They just literally combined two animes. Okay, but yeah, I don't actually watch Sailor Moon, just saying. I just watch, like, the popular animes, like Demon Slayer, My Hero Academia, and all those others. I also wanna watch Attack on Titan, because, you know, it's cool and all the stuff, those edits as well, so... Oh, speaking of something, I just realized. Let me just type in something. Okay, on Tuesday, it's basically like a song or like a music thing, I don't know. So, yeah, it's basically like a meme most of the time. That's actually said by people. Or, I don't know. There we go. Okay, Aaron. So, basically, Aaron Yeager. So, basically, if you know him, he's like... yeah, there we go, this one. So, he's from Attack on Titan, the anime. And I literally obsessed with it. Like, I imagine myself in some of these scenes right now. Like, you know how badass I look, like, literally. What? But I was saying, yeah, that was you again, Draco. I feel like you, or maybe Raja, is literally not talking, right? I don't know, but what is this? If I lose it all, that's probably Attack on Titan as well, yeah. If you, let me just see. This is the meme. The edit. This is so amazing. Although I wish, like, you know, on Tuesday, I wish this, like, meme or song or whatever is actually, like, audio is actually, like, made with, like, the creepypastas because they're not, like, popular and many people don't actually, like, put it, like, animate them anymore. I don't know why, but, like, yeah, isn't this so amazing? This is Aaron, sorry. Because last time, I always used to call him Aaron, but it's actually not, it's actually Aaron, so you know. What a beautiful and handsome name. Look at him, he's also beautiful. Don't tell me. Look, I do not seem for him, I'm just saying. Yeah, he's good looking, that's what I'm trying to say, so you know. Of course, I'm more in the creepypasta fandom, so you know. Can you cut the video? I think I literally made Panda more quiet than usual. I think that was my mistake on... Yeah, I think it's actually your mistake. I don't know why, but I feel like he's gonna have, like, a deep emotional depression after I say that to his favorite character, Deku. Like, literally, I don't know why I don't like Deku anymore. Like, I used to think he's a nice and, I don't know, kind boy, but now I feel like he's more like a weak... Okay! I'm sorry, what? I'm sorry. Oh, come on! Draco, and I thought you said that you already know what I'm gonna say. Exactly, now shut up. Like, literally, you know what I was about to say. But Panda doesn't. So I was almost about to say it, but then I memorized. Then I should remember it also, you know. I'm sorry, what? Hey, look, I'm just gonna cut the video. I just don't want this video to... Okay, now it's literally 10%. Okay, but yeah, this is gonna be the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed this lovely video I made. Can't believe it's almost dark here now. Yeah, sorry for my squad literally being so quiet right now. Yeah, they've never been this way before, but you know, just gonna leave them be like this, okay? But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Bye. Yeah, bye, guys.